Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure and privilege to introduce this program dedicated to a great singer whose rise to world fame has been swift and sensational. It was as recently as February 1959 that the glorious voice of Joan Sutherland was first heard in the title role of Lucia di Lammermoor on a historic night at the Royal Opera House Covent Garden. Since then, her battle honors, if I may so describe them, have included triumphs at La Scala, Milan, the Paris Opera, the Met, the famous Met in New York, and many other citadels of music. One of her most cherished ambitions remains unfulfilled, to sing again in her native Australia. Now at least she is singing to Australia and to the world. With her is the London Symphony Orchestra and two fellow Australians, her husband Richard Bonning as conductor and accompanist, and mezzo-soprano Margareta Elking. The program begins with the overture to Offenbach's La Belle Hélène, played by the London Symphony Orchestra, conducted by Richard Bonning. Thank you. Now here is Joan Sutherland to sing an aria from Meyerbeer's opera Les Huguenots. This is a dramatic, even melodramatic account of the events leading up to the massacre of St. Bartholomew's Eve in Paris in 1572, when many hundreds of French Protestants were killed by their Catholic fellow countrymen. The Queen, Marguerite de Valois, believed in religious toleration, and much of the story of the opera concerns her efforts to avoid bloodshed by arranging a marriage between Valentine, the daughter of a Catholic leader, and Raoul, a young Huguenot. Here, in the garden of her home, the castle of Chenonceau on the Loire, she sings lyrically of the beauty of her country, a better setting for love than for civil war.
Thank you.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Joan Sutherland is joined by her great friend, Margareta Elkins. They met as rival competitors in a song competition in Sydney in 1949. They first sang together as colleagues in the famous production of Lucia 10 years later, and more recently they made a great success together in Alcina. They are going to sing now a duet from Norma by Bellini. This is a relatively early Italian opera. It was first produced in 1831, and according to my opera book, which was published in 1931, it would be difficult to revive successfully today. Well, be that as it may, a production is planned for next year with Joan Sutherland. Ms. Sutherland's already had great successes in the composer's works in La Sonnambula, in I Puritani, and in Beatrice di Tenda, and she's regarded as the chief interpreter of Bellini's music today. Norma, she tells me, is the greatest and most exacting of soprano roles. And happily also, it provides an opportunity for a mezzo-soprano, a favorite role for mezzo-sopranos. They're going to sing a duet then. Adalgisa, a virgin in the Druids' temple in Roman-occupied Gaul, announces to her priestess, Norma, that she is in love with the Roman governor of the province, Pollione. So is Norma. And this situation is a problem for both of them, and however, their friendship triumphs over it. So here we have Mira o Norma from Norma by Bellini. Bonning now comes to the piano with Alexander Murray, principal flautist of the London Symphony Orchestra, to accompany Joan Sutherland in The Gypsy and the Bird by Julius Benedict.
La 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 Anzi, il barone, un ferito, però migliore. Alfredo è in strano suolo. Il vostro sacrificio io stesso gli ho svelato. Egli a voi tornerà per il suo perdono. Io curverò. Curatevi, versate un avvenire migliore. Giorgio Germont.
The stories of many of the operas are naive, old-fashioned, melodramatic, some are plain silly. Presented as plays without music, there are very few of them that would run for a week. And yet, With great singing and great music, these same stories can arouse in us the most profound emotions we ever feel in a theater. Such is the power of music and the human voice. These thoughts are suggested by the contrast between the banal story of Donizetti's Linda di Chamonix, a sort of Victorian cautionary tale with watercolor illustrations, and the haunting beauty of the duet you are about to hear. The story, Linda, a pure Alpine maiden, innocently installed in a Paris apartment, sings of her happiness with Pierrot, a street singer from her native village, who happens to be passing by. So much for the story. Here is the duet.
Oh, 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 oh,
Ladies and gentlemen, we have heard Joan Sutherland in her favorite role, in another which she considers the most exacting in her repertoire. Now, to end the program, the most famous scene in her most famous role of all, the mad scene from Lucia di Lammermoor. The story of Joan Sutherland and Lucia is a remarkable one. Orchestras and fellow artists applauded her at rehearsals. She's had the same effect on us today. Audiences rose to her, stamping and cheering, interrupting the performances for minutes on end. It happened in London, it happened in Milan, Paris, New York, and it's safe to say it will go on happening wherever she sings it. The story? Lucia is the sister of Lord Henry Ashton. She loves Edgar of Ravenswood. It's a Romeo and Juliet situation because the two families are bitter enemies. When Lord Henry discovers it, he does two things to stop it. He shows Lucia a forged document which purports to show that Edgar is unfaithful to her, and he arranges for her to marry another nobleman. As she signs the marriage contract, Edgar, who has been abroad, returns to claim her hand. The agony of grief turns her brain. That night, she murders her bridegroom. Look and listen to what follows.
Thank you.
prepared.